News Channel 8 broke the story, and tonight a videotape that police say shows an animal rights advocate beating her own dog is sparking international outrage. Patrick Bell has new information.
Yeah, Todd, more troubling details to report tonight. Officers tell us this woman also purposely trimmed her dog's nails until they bled, hoping that the sheer pain would stop the animal from digging in the backyard. And the suspect is now defending her actions via social media, but instead of stirring support, she sparked online rage.
It's tough to watch.
Shocking. You know, it's absolutely shocking to see something like this.
Even tougher to comprehend.
To me, that's abuse.
This undercover video, first obtained by News Channel 8, shows, investigators say, an Ottumwa animal rights advocate beating a defenseless dog.
Disgusting.
The suspect, Noelle Stanbridge, faces one misdemeanor count of cruelty to animals. And while she refused to tell us her side of the story, she's apparently taken to social media to defend her actions. On Facebook, Stanbridge states, "All I was doing with her was reprimanding her. All I was doing was tapping her on her butt and feet for digging and for baring teeth and growling at me." That comment drew hundreds of angry responses. Darcy Heston, posting from Australia, writes, "Noelle, the video doesn't lie. What you did was vicious to that poor dog." Cindy Berman follows with, "That dog was trying to escape you. You are a monster." Stanbridge counters later, stating, "Yes, I was tapping her. I didn't have rage." But from the virtual world to the real world, similar reactions.
It was brutal. Nothing should be treated that way. Nothing.
In fact, the Animal Rescue League, one of the state's leading animal welfare organizations, now calling for tougher laws.
I think we do need stiffer penalties in the state. You know, if it's determined that there is animal cruelty, you know, in situations like this or others, that they do face more fines, more, you know, more punishment.
And we've just learned Ottumwa police officers were back at the suspect's home this evening to serve yet another search warrant. No dogs were taken, Todd, and no arrests were made this evening.
Well, Patrick, what about those other 9 dogs at this house?
Well, they're going to stay pending a judge's ruling, which could happen within the next few days or by the end of the week.
Okay, thanks for keeping track, Patrick.